Math 31, welcome to example 7. So we have to write an explicit formula for the following arithmetic sequence. Okay, arithmetic, right, again, I'm gonna have a D involved, sequence. I've got a list of numbers. And you know, if I look at my list of numbers, even though this says arithmetic, even if it didn't, if it just said sequence, I could see that it was arithmetic because I can see the common difference here. Right, to get from 50 to 47, I subtract 3. To get from 47 to 44, I subtract 3. So there's a couple things I wanna just take note of right away. I can see that D is equal to negative 3. And again, it's always good to identify your first term. All right, and so once I see that it's arithmetic, or I just read that it is arithmetic, I get this. I know that A sub n is equal to A sub 1 plus n minus 1 times D. Because again, anytime you have an arithmetic sequence, you get to use this formula. And this formula has four variables, the a sub nth term, the a sub 1th term, right, the first term, n itself, and then d. And I already have the two critical pieces. I have a sub 1 and I have d. So let's plug these in. So I would get 50 here, plus n minus 1 times negative 3. Let me go ahead and distribute. This would be 50. All right, negative 3 times n is negative 3n. Negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. So if I simplify this a little bit, I'm looking at a sub n being 53 minus 3n, okay? Or you could have written it the other way. You could have, if you prefer, right, a sub n equaling negative 3n plus 53. Both of those are great, and that's all there was to this question. Did I write an explicit formula for the nth term? Sure did. So those are my two possible answers. I'm good with either one of them. All right, so we're gonna flip to example 8 and we're gonna practice using this formula one last time. All right, I'll see you in a few. Bye.